Welcome to this instructional video on 3D printed concrete weight molds. First is assembly. Originally designed for filament, my tolerances were a little bit too tight, so I used these picture pins. They're little nails for hanging up pictures. They fit perfectly. They snap right in. I place those in all the smaller holes in all of the lower parts. Of course, you'll do this for all of the lower parts first. I'm only illustrating with a few here. But you will want to do it for all of them, place them in a circle, and then with the upper parts of the outer ring, you'll see matching holes there. I tend to overlap them for a little bit of added strength. It helps to hold things together. It's a bit easier to arrange things. And you just simply slot them in. Once that's done for the entire ring, we can now start to roughly place the ring on top of some bin plastic here, some trash bag plastic, which will help us with removing the concrete weight. We roughly center the spigot in the middle, which we'll now screw down through the plastic and into the table at the bottom. And we will come back with the inner collar. This collar is set into the concrete at the end. It's effectively the bushing between the weight and the bar. So that will eventually be inside the weight. Everything else is just the mold or a jig. You'll see that I'm here screwing everything in. I'm taking my time screwing, you know, every second or third screw. To make sure that everything is properly placed, roughly equally centered. I'm also feeling on the inside of the mold to make sure that it's nice and smooth. That's generally aesthetic. Now we'll start to prepare the mold. I use just cooking oil. I've used olive oil. I've used sunflower oil. I've used tung oil. I don't really see much difference between them, so I don't think it really matters what you use. But just oil inside the mold and on the plastic can perhaps help. And then here you just see some fiber-reinforced concrete premix that I've used, which I then pour into the mold. And here I'm going to use a reciprocating saw to vibrate the concrete. You don't want to over-vibrate. That is a thing. You just want to remove a lot of the bigger bubbles. Some bubbles will always remain, but you don't want to separate the aggregates down to the bottom. Once that's done, a final little pass on the top to making a nice clean top surface. Using everything is at the proper height to make that nice and level. And I'll just fold that over to keep it nice and damp for about 24 hours or so. So 24 hours later, now we can remove our top plastic here. And with that plastic on top, meniscus forces have pulled any of that kind of scummy, powdery stuff that tends to sit on top of concrete to the top. And now I can just scrape that off before I move on to the disassembly phase. So now at disassembly, I simply remove the screws one by one when I can. I should have really put some masking tape on the screws. You'll see there's two here that I have a bit of difficulty removing. It doesn't stop me removing the weight from the mold, but maybe think of that when you do this yourself the next time. The chamfer allows a flathead screwdriver to simply pry apart the parts when they're a bit stuck, but otherwise it should just cleanly come away. As you can see here, there's nothing stuck to the mold. I will now peel the plastic off the bag, and this should happen easily enough with or without mold release. I really do think the oil may be a bit of a cargo cult thing there. I don't think it's absolutely necessary given the multi-part nature of my mold with the plastic here. But you will see that the spigot in the middle here can get stuck. It's easy enough to remove. You simply tap it with a needle nose pliers in this case, or some other kind of blunt edge tool, and then eventually you just poke it out through with your finger. And there's your weight. You can now move on to the next stage, which is perhaps the most important, which is curing. Curing is where you need to allow the concrete to crystallize properly over the course of several days. You need to keep it damp, not necessarily fully wet, but certainly damp. So you'll see that I just get another bin bag here, or trash bag. You'll see that it's damp on the inside. It does need to be soaking wet, but it does need to have enough water in there to make sure that everything will remain nice and humid for several days. I place the weight inside and simply seal it up. And this curing process generally takes, 4 to 7 days. They say that 28 days is the absolute full strength, but our purposes here, 4 to 7 days is more than enough. And I simply leave that somewhere at room temperature out of direct sunlight for about a week. And then when it comes out, it'll be a nice, solid weight mold ready to paint, or not.